Hello and welcome to Arvidalia, hometown of Noah and family. The people of Noah's day were terribly wicked. God saw that their hearts were focused on only evil. God was heartbroken, sorry he had made the human race. The solution? Well, it involved a great flood and Noah's ark and family of Noah. I hope you enjoy your story. And now, it's our pleasure to present to you Captain Noah and the one and only Zoo Cruise for Twos.
The weather was hot, not a cloud in the sky and very sunny. The chances of rain, well, let's just say don't let your camels on it. Noah is known by locals as being a couple of bagels short of a picnic for building an ark in such a hot and dry place. But friends, Noah knew the truth. As sure as does Jehovah, it's gonna rain.
Thank you. Noah's son, Shem, was a lumberjack of the family. He knew one thing, wood. More importantly, go for wood and tons of it. It would be an enormous ark. It would have to be big enough to fit at least two of every animal and three decks. Shem was unsure how much tons was. In other words, how much wood should a woodchopper chop if a woodchopper should chop wood? Noah was pretty sure it would be a long century, and it would be no walk in a park to build this ark.
Yeah.
until finally all the animals and birds were bored. Noah then joined his family for the voyage to a brand new world, a fresh start. We now understand that our purpose is Jesus Christ our Savior. Only by placing our faith in Jesus can we be spared when judgment comes at the end of age.
As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of Son of Man. For in the days before the flood, people were eating, drinking, marrying, and giving in marriage. Up to the day Noah entered the ark, they knew nothing about what was going to happen when the flood came and took them all the way. That is how we have to be at the coming of Son of Man.
There you have it, in Jesus' own words. Just as people were unprepared for the judgment at the time of the flood, there will be those who are unprepared for Jesus' return. The message of Noah's Ark in this: don't wait until it's too late. Receive the love and forgiveness of Jesus now, while there's still time. Two by two, they went into the ark, but today people receive salvation by faith in Christ, not two by two, but one by one. When Noah and his family and all the animals were on board, their journey was just beginning. God was making them a part of his kingdom. Just like all of us, we are kids of his kingdom.
Yeah!
people that didn't survive the flood. However, God had been very patient, and if there had been any other way, he would have chosen it. Our loving God takes no pleasure in the death of the wicked. The rain brought God's judgment, but it also brought his mercy for a fresh start. Then Noah prayed. Lord God Jehovah, we have obeyed you completely. Now please fulfill your word from so many years ago. Send your rain.
Thank you.
Despite all the rambling, during the rains, Noah's family lived inside the ark with all the animals. Life was starting to get a little crazy. After 40 days and 40 nights, they started getting cabin fever. It was smelly and cramped, and all they wanted to do was open a window. They started telling bad jokes like, what song did the family sing while they were on the ark? Despite all the grumbling, Noah was proud of his three sons. Hands and weather reports were right on the money. Sam was a tremendous lumberjack, and Zipus was zootastical. The family started to wonder how much longer it would be until they would be off the ark. Well, Noah told them to have patience, just a few more days until it would be dry enough.
Are perfectly revealed through his son, Jesus Christ, the light of the world.